Det märkas det svärt i full den flyger väck till landstärnen. Det har faktiskt funnits ringmärket tärnor på Antarktis, alltså ringmärket här på Färöarna, så det ser lite om hur långt den lilla fågel kan färdas. Det kan också märkas till fåglarna som græsser på de stejle fjällsidor här till höger. Det är see a lot of sheep here, and just consider that these sheep are actually lambing their lambs out here on these steep mountain sides. They have access to some shelter in these huts, these sheds that you can see one of them just across here, but there's plenty of these sheds in the Faroe Islands, or yeah, spread around the landscape, and basically the sheep, they live outside all their lives. Get around and use them for summer houses during the summer. You'll be given some safety hats, and this is for your own safety, of course, because we're going a little bit closer to land, and little stones can fall down, of course, but it's not going to be. Höjden är cirka 300 meter. Kikar man upp i luften så ser man mellebockar där uppe. Det är den fågel som vi har mest där på Färöarna. Ser den här fritstående klippen som ligner lite på en elefant, och därför så har den också fått det här önamn Elefantklippen, som selvfølgelig er dens riktige navn, men I kan nok se at den ligner lidt en elefant. Og på toppen er der en koloni med lunter. Man kan måske lige skimme det her græsset op. Det har lidt mørkere farve end græsset på fastland. In the front of the boat you can see the highest of the mountains. Peaks visible on this tour. You can see Mount Torskorarhot, which is 645 meters. It's the fourth of these peaks that you see in front of us. står nu, da vi sejler ind imellem her, så kan I se Longyear, som sidder på en god plads deroppe til venstre. Longyear, it's Guillemots that you can see on the left-hand side of the boat. Guillemots, sitting up there on the breeding place. On the boat, you can see the tallest of the freestanding stacks. This one is 144 meters. 144 meters. Grupper, ikke sådan flere hundrede sammen, men nogle, ja, op til 10, måske 20 fugle.
They're just retired,
mm. They said one had to suffer for health, and now. This is topped with egg yolk mixed with potato, cream, and dashi. Now the reason we received a very small spoon for this matter is of course due to the need of tasting all these three layers at the same time. So not the entire portion per se, but all three layers. We're digging very deeply. Also keep in mind that the fake white egg does not have a flat bottom. As such, we'll be holding it in our hands while we consume this dish. No process. It is topped with caviar from a Belgian producer called Gastro Unica, and it's one of a species of sturgeon, the eggs from the sturgeon in the caviar, called osetta of Hojicha Polio. Hojicha being a Japanese tea that would brew at slightly lower temperatures than you would regularly do. It is spiced, or seasoned if you may, with hazelnut oil.
Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So-called Covent Garden into the cup with a large ice bottle in it, ice cube in it. Now from the black bottle, a homemade rhubarb extract. After that has been poured in the very small bottle you find here, we have some lemon. Some guest of us called it the first injection a few days ago. I can't vouch for that necessarily. We stir it and top it with tonic water from a Swiss producer called Jent, slightly less bitter than your average tonic, and as such more suited for another tonic cocktail. The gentleman is having Albariño. Albariño is a grape grown predominantly in Galicia, the northwestern part of the Iberian Peninsula, both on the Spanish and the Portuguese sides of the border.
It's just been exposed to the natural microclimate that is outside here. It's a very traditional way to preserve meat, and we've actually frozen it so that we are able to grade it.
And then we finish it off with a cheese sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
I've never tried that before.
Okay.
And I went. Just.
Thank you.
Taxiing for the next few minutes, so please remain seated with your carry-on stowed.